Hi to all. Today we will discuss how to draw a hypocycloid. I took one textbook question here. Before doing this, first let us take what is hypocycloid. Hypocycloid means it is path of one P point. This P point is on the circumference of the smaller circle. Okay. When the smaller circle is rotating inside a bigger circle. Okay. Let us take one example. I took one bigger circle here. Okay. And then I took one smaller circle. I have marked one P point here. Okay, which is, let us assume, on the circumference of the circle. Okay, let us take here. Okay, now this circle is rotating inside a bigger circle like this. Okay, it is moving with the help of the direction of the bigger circle. Okay, now here hypocycloid means it is a path traced out by this P point. Let us assume P point is initially here. Okay, here I am marking. This is a P point initially. Okay, now when it is rotating like this, this P point is coming here. I will mark here. I will take bigger one so that it is visible. And then it is rotating here. Mark this P point here. Trace of this P point. Okay. This, move this circle and then mark here. So this circle is making one rotation, complete rotation. Okay. These are the P points. This is the starting P point. This is the end point. If you join all the P points, this path of the P point. So starting point to end point, we got one curve. Is it visible? Okay. So this path is known as hypocycloid. Okay. So how to define hypocycloid means? A hypocycloid is a curve traced out by a point on the circumference of the circle which rolls along the another circle and inside it. Okay. It is moving inside this bigger arc without slipping. Okay, without any slipping, it is moving, it is making one complete rotation. Okay, this arc is called, this path is called hypocycloid. So here it is doing one complete rotation of the smaller circle. Okay, here we had to do one hypocycloid. Okay, so the smaller diameter of the circle is 50 mm. I have written with small d, it is 5 cm. And then which rolls inside a circle of diameter 180 mm. Bigger circle diameter is capital D, 180 mm, that is 18 cm for one revolution. Also draw a tangent and normal to the hypocycloid at a point 50 mm from the center of the directing circle. Always remember, directing circle means bigger circle. Okay. So this is the given data. First we do the hypocycloid, after that we do the tangent and normal to this curve. Okay. Here if you do the diagram, rough diagram, the bigger circle is like this. Okay. What is the diameter here? 180 mm or 18 cm. What is the radius of it? 9 cm. I am taking it is capital R. Is 9 cm. What is a smaller radius? Here 5 cm means half in it, 2.5 cm. Okay. So first we need to do the bigger circle. For doing this arc, we have to find one center. We have to take any point on the center. Take the bigger arc. R is equal to how much? Radius is 9 cm. Do the arc. Here, for complete one rotation of the circle, so this is the smaller circle, it is rotating like this. Okay, so here we have one formula for making one complete rotation, how much length it is traveling in terms of angle. So this formula is, we are taking this angle 360 degrees into small d by capital D. Okay, 360 degrees into what is the smaller diameter? 50 mm. What is the bigger diameter? 180 mm. So this is 100 degrees. Okay. So this, first do this line and take 100 degrees. And do this line of the same radius, do this bigger arc. Okay, let us do this diagram here by using the instruments. First mark any point as a center. Let us do the hypocycloid by using the instruments. Initially we have to take one center, any point, taking this is the center. Okay, O is the center. Now take the bigger radius, do any one line here. Okay, how much length it is? 9 cm. So 9 cm, take one line, mark this point is P point. Okay. Now here after that take 100 degrees here with this reference line. Take 100 degrees. So here 80, 90, this is 100. Join center to this point. This length is 9 cm. This is the 9 cm. Just join with the center. Make it dark here. Now take this is the Q point. This is the starting point. This is the end point. Okay, and make an arc here with the help of compass. Take O as center, OP as radius. Do an arc here, which is joining P and Q. Here, after getting this arc, here do one smaller circle. What is the smaller circle diameter? It is 5 cm. So initially mark here on it. The diameter is 5 cm, and mark the middle point also 2.5. So this is the diameter of the bigger circle. Now this is the center. Take this is C point. Now after getting C point, take C as center, CP radius. Do a circle. C as center, CP radius. Do one circle here. So after getting this circle, divide this circle into 12 equal divisions. Okay, for any circle at the center, angle is 360 degrees. Okay, so divide this 360 degrees into 12 divisions. So 360 degrees divided by 12. Each part is 30 degrees. Okay, so by using the protractor, take 30 degrees points. So this is, this diameter is a reference one. From here I am taking 30 degrees. 30 plus 30 again, 60 degrees at one, 60 degrees one part. 60 plus 30 means 90. 90 plus 30 means 120. 120 plus 30 means 150. Okay, here we got the points. Join all these points to the center within the circle. I am joining this point to center. So this point to center and extend this line. This here I have extended this line. Okay, as we know, circle is symmetrical about any diameter. Okay, this diameter. Now take this point, join to center. Do the line within the circle. Now this point. This point is. Now we have divided into 12 equal divisions. After getting the divisions, give the points here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. This P point I am giving as 12 also. Okay. After dividing into 12 parts, divide this 100 degrees angle, that is this arc, into 12 divisions. So how to divide 100 degrees into 12 divisions? 100 divided by 12. So do with calci. So we are getting 8.333 like that. So 8 degrees we can mark by using the protractor. Okay, 8 degrees we can mark. So this is 5, 6, 7, 8. But 8.3 how can we mark? So here we have to mark 8.3, 8.3 like that, 12 divisions. So I am using trial and error method for dividing into 12 divisions. So in trial and error method, first initially mark 8. After 8, you have to mark approximately 1 point. Okay. Mark the angle initially by using pencil. Take, so initially mark 8 degrees. This is 5, 6, 7, 8. After 8 I am taking little distance. I am marking 1 point approximately. I am taking, okay, after 8 1 point. So join this point to this point by using the pencil. You have to do it. So this point to center you join and extend up to this arc, bigger arc. So take this length, this is a P point. And this is the angle we are taking. So take that angle by using the compass. Take this angle by using the compass. Just mark here, already we did one part. And this is the second one. This is the third part. This one is the fourth one. This is the fifth part. Sixth part. Seventh one. 8th one, 9th one, 10th one, 11th one. Here we got only 11 parts, but we have to divide into 12 divisions. Whatever radius we are taking, just reduce it, reduce the length between these two points, and again redraw these arcs. Remove these arcs for initially. Okay, instead of the previous one, take the smaller radius. Okay, So in trial and error method, first remove these arcs. What I did, instead of previous radius, I took smaller than that one. Okay, again I am marking, this is the first part, this is the second part, this is the third one, this is the fourth one, fifth one, sixth one, seventh one, eighth one, ninth one, tenth one, 11th one, we got 12th one. Okay, so exactly we have divided this into 12 equal divisions. So this method is called trial and error method. So here whatever intersection points are coming, give the names. One, this is the first point, 1 dash, this is the second one, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash, 6 dash, 7 dash, 8 dash, 9 dash, 10 dash, 11 dash, this Q point I am giving 12 dash. Okay, after getting these points, so join all these points to center with the help of scale.
Inside of me, in this desert I can look at you with love, seeing all that I can learn. Can you stay and I will grow, grow the hanging guy.
After joining all the points to the center, as I told, this circle is rotating inside it, okay, inside the bigger arc. So center is also moving, okay, so which is parallel to this main curve, and all the points are also moving. Okay, that's why we had to shift all these points on the arc. So here I am taking, initially this is the center for all the points, so I will do at the center one arc. So take OC is the radius, O as center, just do an arc here like this. So all centers are moving on this arc. Now similarly, I am taking the last point, O as center, O6 is the radius. So this sixth last end point will move on this end curve. Okay. Similarly, at all the points, do the arc with O as center. O as center, O1 is the radius, 11 and 1 are coming on the same arc. So this is the first arc, this is the 11, 1 arc. Take O as center, O2 as radius, do an arc which is passing through 10 and 2. So do an arc here. Next radius is 0, 3. O as center, next radius is O3. So which is passing through, next radius is O3. So which is passing through 9, 3. Next is O4. Now 4 and 8 are moving on the same arc. And so next is O5. 7 and 5 are on the coming on the same arc. So like that we did arcs at all the points. So after getting all the arcs, our main aim is we need to trace out this P point. Okay, P point is initially here. So it is moving like this from one center to another center. Okay. So here we need to mark the centers initially. So on the center arc, this is the center arc which is passing through C. So I am taking the first. So from C to C1 center I am taking. C1 center is on the first line. Okay, C1, mark C1. And then center 2 is on the second line. C2. And then third line C3. C4. C5. C6. C7. C8. C9. C10, C11, and this is the C12. Okay, so centers are moving. We need to draw the path of P point. When center is moving from C to C1, where the P point is. But the center to P point distance is same because same circle is moving. Now whatever radius of the smaller circle, we have to take that radius by using this compass. Take the radius of the smaller circle. Okay, initially P point is here. Okay. Now when it is shifting to C1, just do an arc on the first line. It is moving from P2 P1. Again from C2 second line we have to do the arc which is passing through 2 second arc. Okay, P2, so initially P it is moving here, again it is moving here, again C3 center on the third line which is passing through 3 arc. Okay, C4 center on the fourth, where it is on the fourth arc, and then C5 to fifth one, so this is passing through fifth, and C6 to sixth one, so it is here, so from sixth. Okay, C7 to seventh one, 7-5 on the fifth one, C8 to eighth arc, so on this arc, so C9 to ninth one, so 9-3 arc is passing on the same, C10 to 10th arc, this one is the 10th one, so C11 to 11th one, this one is C12 to this one, last. So give the names of the intersection points. These intersection points are, we are tracing the P path, so this is P1 and this is P2, this is P3, after P3 this is a P4 and this is P5 and this arc is P6, P7, P8, this is P9, P10, P11, P12. Okay, if we join all the P points, we are getting the hypocycloid. Join all the P points with the freehand curve. So this path is called hypocycloid. Make it dark. This curve is called hypocycloid. For this curve, we have to draw a tangent and normal, okay, at a point 5 cm from the center of the directing circle. Already I told directing circle means it is a bigger circle. So from the, we have to take 1.5 cm from the center of the directing circle. Okay, by using the compass, take 5 cm distance. Okay, this distance is from the center of the bigger circle. From the center of the bigger circle means O is a bigger circle center. From this, we have to take one point on the curve. We can take this side or this side. Okay, at this point, intersection point, I am taking, this is M point. We need to draw normal and tangent. Take this radius by using compass. Okay, radius of the smaller circle, so M as center, draw an arc on the center curve, okay, which is passing through all centers. So we got one point here, take this point is some X point. After getting X point here, join O and X, this center to X, and extend up to this curve. Join OX and extend up to this point. Okay, take this point is, the intersection point is N. Join N and M, it is a normal. Okay, here N, this end point is N dash. N, N dash is a normal. As we know, tangent is perpendicular to normal. That is 90 degrees. So take this is N, N dash. So 90 degrees means here. Join M to this point, it is a tangent. So here I am giving name T, T dash. Okay, T, T dash is a tangent, N, N dash is a normal, and the angle between tangent and normal is 90 degrees. And mark the given dimension, the smaller circle diameter is 50 mm and the radius of the bigger circle is 90 mm. And this M point is from the center, it is 50 mm. And MX distance is radius of the smaller circle, that is 25 mm. And this is the hypocycloid. For epicycloid and cycloid videos also we did. I will give the video link in description box. Please check it. Thank you for watching.